Please welcome back to my YouTube channel. So we're here at Tagdilaran, Bohol Port. Para po sa mga hindi nakakalam, this video is continuation po siya ng DIY travel vlog ko from Bohol going to Cebu. So today, we arrive here at Tagdilaran Port at 7 a.m. because ang departure time namin is 8:20 a.m. By the way, 1 week before kami nag-travel sa Bohol, nakapag-book na kami ng Ocean Jet and no need na rin i-print yung itinerary receipt. For one-way ticket from Bohol to Cebu is 800 pesos and service fee na 62 pesos, 10 tourist cash yung pinili namin. Finally, we're here at Cebu. All our expenses and itinerary, lalagay ko na lang siya sa description down below. After port, dimiretso na kami sa accommodation namin. This is our first stop, welcome to Taoist Temple. The place was built to serve as a center of Taoism worship in the city. However, due to its location and stunning design, the Taoist Temple has also now become a tourist spot. Taoism is a religion that heeds the ancient teachings of the Chinese philosopher Laozi. In the temple, devotes perform ritual. One ritual is where one prays to the gods to grant one wish. The Taoist Temple is no entrance fee, so you can just go in if you want. And you don't need to worry about the parking because there is a parking area and still no fee. The Taoist Temple has magnificent buildings and different offerings, with halls, statues, garden, and even industries. It also contains different building spaces for different purposes. Taoist Temple is one of the most visited non-Catholic shrines in Cebu. Located in Beverly Hills subdivision in Lahok, this temple was built by Cebu's Chinese community in 1972 on a hillside 300 meters above sea level. After this Taoist Temple, nagutom na kami kaya pumunta na kami sa pinakamalapit na chowki. I ordered chowpan and shomai. Hindi ko alam po ano meron sa Cebu, bakit ang hilig nila sa ketchup. So the next destination is Temple of Leah. Temple of Leah is open daily from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. and the entrance fee is 120 pesos. 10 years old below are free. So what's the story behind the Temple of Leah? It is built as a symbol of undying love and never-ending devotion of Chidorico Adarna to his wife Leah Villa Albino Adarna. Mr. Adarna shared that he constructed this temple in the year of 2012 as a symbol of his undying love for a ceaseless devotion to her wife. Sa mga nagtatanong kung related ba si Ellen Adarna sa Temple of Leah, the answer is yes. Ellen is the granddaughter of Chidorico Adarna and Leah Villa Adarna. Sobrang calm and relaxing na vibe dito. The popular tourist spot in Cebu is Sirao Flower Farm or Sirao Garden. Here, you can find different types of flowers and plants of all colors, shapes, and sizes. The garden is curated using seeds brought from Amsterdam. And because of the many replicas of Amsterdam's themes, structures, and windmills, aside from the flowers, Sirao Garden also offers breathtaking views of the surrounding mountains and cityscape. Whether you're exploring the garden paths or simply relaxing in the one of the gazebos, you'll be treated to panoramic views that will take your breath away. Hello guys! Good morning! So, OOTD check tayo. Actually, nakapang swimming na ako, then pinatong po na lang yung jacket ko kasi manamig sa biyahe. Then 3 hours away siya from our accommodation. First stop, pinag-breakfast muna nila kami para daw pagdating sa Moalboal, diretso activities na. The way guys, yung sabi nung pala namin na tour, isusunduin nila kayo sa mismo accommodation nyo, kaya no need to worry na. Then 3 a.m. dapat naka-ready na kayo. Dun sa tour na binook namin, included na lahat. Tour guide, entrance fee, and van. And meron din silang pa-free lunch. So let's go to the Moalboal! The sardine run is totally wild, unpredictable event. But when everything comes together, the sardine run is the most spectacular wildlife spectacle on the planet. To be honest, this is probably a better decision, as they probably know the best spots for spotting the sardines run and turtles. We pick a really good day to do this. The weather is amazing, so therefore, the water was so clear and we spotted so many different types of fish. Looking at all the detail of the coral was just mind-blowing. I will say that the reality of this is that are a lot of people on the island that want to do the same thing. So bear this in mind, give the animals the space they need, and remember that the sea is not a zoo. So you aren't always guaranteed to see the turtles and the sardines. But just look at how incredible this is. Open your eyes to the beauty surrounding you regardless. Enjoy it and be safe. Either way, please don't touch the turtles. Otherwise, may penalty kayo na 2,500 pesos. Once daw kasi na na-touch yung turtles, lumalayo siya.
Hello guys! Ano masasabi niyo sa experience today?
Super and strong. Yun!
Marunong si Ma'am, oh! So, what's up, mananap? We're here at Moalboal. Yung mga kakampan nyo na kasama ko.
Super enjoy talaga yung sardines run and turtle watching. So now, let's go to the canyoneering adventure. Oh, this is it. Welcome to Alegria, Cebu. Let's begin the canyoneering adventure. Medyo nakakasad lang kasi close yung Kawasan Falls. Then meron din silang short orientation from the local tour guide. After orientation, kailangan yung sumakay ng motor kasi malayo din siya. Then dun palang mag-i-start yung adventure. Sobrang init ngayon dito at ang hapdi sa balat. Kaya much better kung mag-sunblock kayo and rash guard kasi yung biyahe is 10 to 15 minutes. Then guys, advice pala for those na nagpa-plan mag-canyoneering. Dapat yung shoes or sandals nyo is nababasa siya. And dapat makakfit kasi sobrang madudulas yung mga bato. Pero yung in-avail naming tour package is included na yung life vest, helmet, and crocs. And also the tour guide. Wala kayong dadalhin na gamit except sa phone. Kasi guys, wala kayong paglalagyan dun. And may times na lumulusong kayo sa tubig. Kaya dapat yung dadalhin yung phone is water resistant. Or bumili kayo ng waterproof na phone case. Paparent din sila ng GoPro for 1,200 pesos. Kahit ilan na kayo dun. Bago kayo makapunta sa adventure, may trekking muna. Kaya much better kung comfortable kayo sa suot ninyo. So this is it, let's go! Welcome to Canyoneering Adventure! Canyoneering is one of the simplest stops attraction. It is a popular outdoor trek that involves traveling down creeks or streams within a canyon through a variety of means including walking, jumping, swimming, and climbing.
Japanese yan? Yung kasama, Japanese yan. Baka English, English. We'll be right back.
Si Hi!
Hi!
Woo! Loob pag din ako magbabalas sa train natin. Ang sorry ka talaga sa akin ha. Magulit-ilis na ako wag naman no. Magulit-ilis ha.
Magkaugaw po ako ng 1-2-3 at tapos nalilin mo tayo talon. Woo!
Ready, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, go! Yan!
After the adventure, sobrang worth it kasi meron ditong mga tindahan. Pansin ang mga tinda ditong barbecue, hotdog, then mga ihaw-ihaw. At syempre, meron din sila ditong local na choco ban na sobrang sarap, as in, with chocolate filling siya and mura 20 pesos isa. Kaya ayan, napatake out tuloy kami. If wala kayong dalang pera, pwede niyo siyang ibigay sa tour guide ninyo mamaya. Sobrang worth it talaga yung canyoneering adventure and super enjoy. Hindi worth it yung pagsisibo mo kung hindi mo na-try to. Bago kami umuwi, dumaan kami dito sa Upo Merkado ng Cebu. Sobrang sasarap ng mga food nila dito and enjoy kaso sobrang daming tao. Sobrang sulit and sobrang mura ng mga bilihin dito. After namin kumain dito at maglibot sa Upo, umuwi na kami sa accommodation namin para magpahinga. Kasi bukas sa flight na namin pa Manila. Bago kami umuwi ng Manila, dumaan pala muna kami dito sa Magellan's Cross para magsimba. Daghang salamat Cebu, sobrang ganda mo at sure ako na babalikan kita. At syempre bago kami umuwi, hindi pwedeng hindi kami bumili ng Ayers Lechon dito sa Mactan Cebu International Airport.